Gary Kenton Richardson. I'm sorry. The truth is that I never thought I would meet someone that truly loved me, that I could ever be myself around, and love me more than anyone except for God. But then the Lord brought me you. You came into my life at the most unexpected time. We weren't that first sight kind of love, but we were so much more than that. I fell in love with you because your heart full of love for God and others. You are the most God-fearing man I know, the most generous, the most loving, the most genuine, the most punny, and so, so much more. I promise to try my best not to be too stubborn on small things. I promise to never fall asleep mad. I promise to be by your side in the worst and the best moments in our life together. I promise to never watch an episode of Stranger Things without you. I promise to be the woman of God I am called to be and to submit to you in the way Christ displays for us. I promise to drink however much coffee I need to when you're trying a new recipe. I vow to you now and in front of everyone to raise our future children in the Lord alongside you, and to support you in all the crazy ideas that come in your head, or I will at least let you down easy. I vow to pray with you every day and read the Word of God with you often. I vow to grow old by your side for as long as the Lord sees fit. Most importantly, I vow to love you every day for the rest of our lives with everything I have, and to keep God at the forefront and center of our relationship always. So here's to forever, my love. I love you so much, Gary Richardson.
What then shall we say to these things? What wondrous love is this? My love, the day is here, and by God's great grace, the time is now, and by that grace alone, I have been given the honor and the utmost privilege to love, serve, protect, cherish, and provide your needs. When I engaged you, Taylor, I was made aware and have since known that my call is to give myself as Christ did for his people. Further, to share, to have, and to delight in all the Lord has given and has thus far made both of us and promised to complete in us. To encourage your heart with a mouth of kindness and an ear willing to listen and to seek to understand. My life, my possessions, my heart, and my soul are committed and dedicated to serve you and those whom the Lord will call us to serve together. My dearest friend and my most beautiful beloved bride, I vow to know you, love you, serve you, encourage you to now dedicate our marriage before God and these witnesses today to testify of God's goodness and his glory from now until he takes us to himself. And though this vow is made by a broken, sinful man, may we know that even at our lowest, sickest, and poorest moments, that God alone is faithful to complete his work and will, by his grace, sustain us until we see and witness the fullness of his work in our marriage.
I now have the honor and privilege of pronouncing you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride.
Gary, I cannot say like what a breath of fresh air it is to see someone truly love my sister the way she deserves to be loved. They settled down beneath my feet. I've got it right and I got it wrong.
But I learned my lesson. If there was one word I could use to describe Gary, it is passionate. He is passionate about God. As his own vows attested earlier today, he is passionate about loving, protecting, and leading Taylor. It is this God-given passion that gives me great confidence that he will succeed in that goal. Here as the night starts falling, let my
fingers walk over your head. Taylor is the most loyal person in the universe. The kindest, the most pure of heart. You love so fiercely and so passionately. And I prayed that someday somebody would be able to love you the way that you love others. And to me, nobody was ever gonna be enough for her. But if anybody could be, it's definitely you. I'm so grateful that Taylor found you, and also that you found Taylor, because these two, they're perfect for each other. The only thing that was for me, and I saw the angels come.